Okay. This is the first email question and bring it on today. This is from Melissa Pat, who says, out of grief, I recently purchased a device that would let me contact the dead. I am a Christian. However, I've always been fascinated by ghosts and the paranormal. I was trying to contact my father, who had passed away recently. A voice did speak to me using my nickname that only my father called me, told me my dead dog's name, and repeatedly told me his first name, which was my father's name. Was this the devil and or his demons trying to deceive me? And if so, why? I asked God to forgive me, and I promised I would never do it again. Did I commit a sin to God? Pat, can you please clarify exactly what the Bible says happens to us when we die?
Well, that's a lot of questions. The Bible says, should a people turn to spirits that peep and mutter and not to the living God? There are people who were called necromancers who were dealing with the dead. Soothsayers and fortune tellers and that kind of thing is condemned by God. As a matter of fact, they were supposed to be stoned to death in the Old Testament. I don't know what kind of a device. That sounds like you talk about a con. I've got a little device in my device shop that will get you in touch with dead people. I mean, come off it. But in any event, what happens when you die? The Bible says that Jesus was talking to a thief on the cross. And the thief said, remember me when you come into your kingdom. And Jesus said, this day you will be with me in paradise. That's what he said to him. You will be with me in paradise. When we die in the Lord, we're with the Lord. And I'll forever be with the Lord. Paul said, whether to be present in the body and apart from the Lord, the idea is you are with the Lord. So when Christians die, they're with the Lord. When somebody else dies apart from the Lord, they're in Sheol, a place of, of waiting, in a sense, for the final judgment. So in any event, that's when you die. But we're not saying, you're not in touch with your father. I know you love him and all that, and you love your mother and your departed loved ones, but you're not in touch with them. God does not open the door of the dead so that we can talk to them.
And tells us not to do that.
Exactly. Yeah. Forbidden. Necromancy. Forbidden. All right.
Okay, this is Pamela, who says, I visited New Orleans as a tourist and out of curiosity went into a voodoo shop against my better judgment. I've not thought about it in 2 years, but recently it's come to mind a few times, and I believe that the Holy Spirit is making me aware of my sin and going into this evil place. I have prayed and asked for forgiveness. I would like advice, please. Do you think I could have opened myself up to any demonic attack from doing this?
Well, you could have, but are you seeing any manifestations? Is something happening strange in your life? If it's not, if you're a Christian, you go into a voodoo shop. God protects us from this stuff. He protects us from evil because we are His. And the blood of Jesus Christ is covering you if you know the Lord. Mm-hmm. But if you're having any kind of strange manifestations, if you're having weird dreams, if you're having weird fears, if apparitions are appearing, then in the name of Jesus, command it, bind it, and command it to leave you in His name, and He'll do it because Jesus is all-powerful. But voodoo is not of God. And anyhow, go ahead.
Okay, this is Joshua, who says, must one believe in the Trinity to go to heaven?
The Trinity is not the easiest subject in the world to understand that there's one God eternally existence in three forms of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So you certainly don't have to believe in that to go to heaven. You have to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you'll be saved. And I think that as you get more mature in the Lord, He'll open to you the workings of the Godhead and the work of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.